हेलो माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग। हाउ आर यू? आई होप यू आर फाइन। दिस इज योर इंग्लिश टीचर एंड टुडे एज यू नो आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द टॉपिक नाउंस। ओके, सो एज यू नो वेरी वेल आई हैव ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन्ड यू अबाउट द नाउंस। सो बिफोर वॉचिंग दिस लेक्चर, first you have to go and watch the explanation of the noun, then you have to come here, because today we are going to solve the exercises of the noun. So these exercises are very basic. So first of all, you need to pause the video and try to solve, and whatever marks you get, just put the below comment section. So now first try to solve it. I hope you have solved it. So now I am going to explain you one by one. Your exercise number one is identify the different kinds of nouns in the following sentences and name them. So here you need to find out the nouns and also to say what kind of noun these are. So this is your first basic questions. So now I am going to explain you. Dhoni is a good batsman. It is a very simple, as you know, Dhoni. So Dhoni is a proper noun. Why? Because if we are talking about particular name of a person, things or animals, this is called a proper noun. So here this is noun, and what kind of noun is this? This is proper noun. So move on the further. A good batsman. Batsman is a common noun, because batsman can be anyone. It may be Rohit Sharma, it may be Virat Kohli, it may be anyone. So here we can say that batsman is a common noun, because batsman can be used for anyone. So you can say that this is a common noun. I hope you have got my point. So now move on the next question. He has good knowledge of cricket. So he has good knowledge. So here you can see here cricket, football, tennis, badminton, these are what kind of nouns? These are very good proper noun, because it is a name of proper game. Okay, so we can say that this is a proper noun. Now move on the here knowledge. As we know very well, here knowledge is a abstract noun. Why? Because we cannot count knowledge, we cannot see knowledge, we can only feel. So that's why we can say that knowledge is a abstract noun. Okay, you can take many examples: wisdom, defense, action, management, honesty, love. These are very good abstract nouns. So you can say that this is noun, but what kind of noun? Abstract nouns. Okay, I hope you have got it, my point. Now move on the question number third. Pawan is a man of great wisdom. Okay, it is a very simple, you can find out here. Pawan is a noun. What kind of noun is this? Is a proper noun, because it is a name of proper person. So now move on further. Man is a very simple. What kind of noun is man? Man is a common noun, because man can be anyone. Man can be your father, man can be your brother, man can be your uncle. So that's why we can say that man is a common noun. So this is common noun. Now move on further. Great is an adjective. Why? Because it is defining wisdom, and wisdom is what kind of noun is? Wisdom is abstract noun, and it is formed by wise. Okay, and wise is an adjective, and wisdom is a noun. And what kind of noun is this? Is abstract noun. What kind of noun is this? Is abstract noun. I hope you got it. Now move on to question number four. For making dessert, we need sugar, milk and honey. So now look, for making the is article. Okay, the is an article, and keep one thing in your mind: whenever article come in any place, so after article, in mostly cases, we got the noun. We can get the noun. So here desert, and desert is noun. And what kind of noun is? Basically, there are many kinds of desert. Desert can be chocolate, desert can be ice cream, and desert can be sugar, and desert can be many more things that are taking after the dinner. That is called desert. So desert is common noun. Okay, I hope you got it, my point. So now move on the further. We need sugar. Very simple. It is a material noun. Why? Because through the material noun, we can make any new things like chocolate, like coffee, like tea. So you can say that this is material noun. Milk is also material noun and honey is also material noun. These are material nouns. I hope you have got it, my points. Now move on to question number 5. A herd of cattle greeted the farmer in his backyard. So now look here, farmer. Farmer is noun, and what kind of noun is? Common noun, because farmer can be anyone. Okay, so here farmer is common noun, and backyard. Backyard is also common noun because there are many kinds of backyards. If backyards related to Mohis, if backyards related to your, okay, so we can say that backyard is a common noun. And one thing keep in your mind, whenever we are talking about common nouns, so in mostly cases we can make the plural of common noun. I hope you have got it, my points. Now look here, herd. Herd is collective noun. Very good. Why? Because it is the collection of animals. Okay, so herd can be collection of cows, and herd can be collection of buffaloes, and herd can be collection of goats. So this is collective noun. And second thing here, cattle. So cattle is here, basically we can consider also collective noun, because whenever we talk about cattle, so in cattle we can consider animals as well as men who are observing and who are directing and who are instructing to those animals. So animals plus man's collection is called cattle. So we can say that this is collective noun. I hope you have got it, the first exercise. If you have any problem in this exercise, try to see this video again, and after that you move on the exercise number 2. So now we are going to solve exercise number 2. It is a very simple. You can see here the instruction, fill in the blanks with appropriate collective nouns. Okay, you need to put here collective nouns, and options are given here. Okay, as I have already written here. So now move on to question number 1. The award ceremony was a pop star since all the popular cricket players were present. So one thing keep in your mind. A collection of stars, what we call the collection of stars, we call galaxy, or we can say that constellations. So means you need to put here constellations, because collection of stars is called constellation. Okay, I hope you have got it, the point. Now move on to question number 2. There was a lawn in front of the stadium before India-Pakistan cricket match began. Means whenever you go in front of the stadium, so before going inside, you make a queue to go inside. Suppose if you want to transact money from the ATM, so you have to stand up in front of some people due to rush. So this is called a queue. Means whenever you pray in your assembly, so you need to make a queue. So your answer is queue. So there was a long queue. What is your answer? Queue in front of the stadium before India-Pakistan cricket match began. I hope you have got it, this point. Wherever Danish went, of puppies followed him. Whenever we are talking about groups of puppies and groups of pigs, children, that is called what? That is called litter. What? Litter. So means group of puppies, group of pigs child is called litter. I hope you have got it, this point. Now move on to question number 4. It is amazing to view a of geese in the sky. So one thing keep in your mind, collection of geese is called what? Collection of geese is called flight. Why? Because mostly if you are talking about birds, birds collection is called also flight because they fly. That's why we can say that flight of geese. During the war, ships guarded the coast. Okay, it is very simple. You have left one, so keep in your mind, collection of ships we call fleet. Okay, whenever you talk about collection of ships we call fleet. So I hope you have got it, my point. Now move on the next exercise. Now these are exercise number 3rd and 4th. First you have to try to solve it, and after your solving I will go to solve it. Okay, now start. I hope you have solved it. Whatever marks you have gained, just try to put below the comment section. Okay, I will personally check each one of your comment. So now move on to exercise number 3rd. Identify the countable and uncountable nouns according to their context. As we know very well, in this word there are two kinds of noun. Basically these are countable and uncountable noun. Whenever you go in anywhere, you have to whenever you find nouns, these nouns may be two types. First one is countable noun and second one is uncountable nouns. You can take here examples. If I'm saying marker, marker is countable noun. If I'm saying board, board is countable noun. If I'm saying your mobile, this is countable noun. But whenever I'm saying here is uncountable noun. Knowledge, knowledge is uncountable noun. Air is uncountable noun. Electricity and uncountable noun. But whenever I say bulb is countable noun. Tube light is countable noun. So I hope you have got it, point. Now we are going to solve question number 1st. His knowledge in maths is impressive. So you can see here, this is possessive adjective, and after possessive adjective always we get noun, and these noun may be any kind of, they may be countable and they may be uncountable noun. So here knowledge, as I have already explained to you, this is uncountable noun, UCN means uncountable noun. In maths, and maths is a subject, so I have already told you, whenever we talk about any subject, any proper noun, so these are also uncountable nouns. So this is also uncountable noun, UCN. So I hope you have got it, my point. Now move on to question number 2nd. His work for the day is over. Very simple, this is possessive adjective, and after possessive adjective work is also uncountable noun. We cannot count work. Okay, so now move on to next. So here you can say that day is countable. It is very simple, and this is countable noun. We can also say this is a common noun. Day, days, year, years, month, months, these are countable noun. Keep one thing in your mind, if noun is countable, so you can make it in plural form, means you can write it in your plural form. So now move on to question number 3rd. We should cultivate good manners. Okay, now look here, manners is uncountable noun because it is related to your behavior, and whatever is related to your behavior, it cannot be see and it cannot be count and it cannot be touched. It can only felt. So that's why we can say that this is uncountable noun. Very good. Now move on to question number 3rd. Books, very simple, countable noun. Books were distributed among the children, the article, and after article I have already explained to you, we get mostly cases noun. Okay, so this is noun, and what kind of noun is this? Countable noun. Why? Because we can count children. Now move on to question number 5th. Her kindness, same things, this is possessive adjective, and possessive adjectives, after possessive adjective we always get nouns. And this noun is basically here is uncountable noun. So you can say that this is uncountable noun. Why? Because kindness, and kindness cannot be count, only it can be felt. Towards the street dogs. Dogs is countable noun. It is very simple. Made her adopt them. There is no any noun. Now move on to exercise number 4th. Fill in the blanks with the noun form of the words given in brackets. Okay. Now here are some fill in the blanks. So you need to fill these blanks after making these words in a noun form. So keep one thing in your mind, whenever you want to make abstract noun, what abstract noun? So basically abstract noun can be made by common noun, by adjective, and by what? Very good. I have explained to you in previous your lecture. Okay, and by verb. Okay, so whenever you make these parts of speech in the form of abstract noun, so you need to put some suffixes or prefixes. Okay, so you know very well suffix and prefix. Whenever we put any words before a word and after the words, before, if we are using before the words, this is called prefix, and after the words, if we are using, this is called suffix. So I have already explained to you, you have to go and watch the previous video, the topic that is basically related to noun, then watch this video. This is also helpful for you. And now look here, the generals has earned him many accolades. Accolades means prize, high prize, we can say that. Okay, so brave, so through the, now look here, brave is here adjective, and here we need to put a noun. So through brave we can make bravery. What? Bravery. And bravery is what? An abstract noun. Bravery is an abstract noun. Bravery. I hope you have got it this point. Now move on to question number 2nd. India gained in the year 1947. What India gained in the 1947? So now look here, this is verb, and through verbs we can make it freedom. What? Freedom. So India gained freedom in the year 1947. I hope you have got it, my points. Now move on to question number 3rd. The ozone layer gave us from the harmful ultraviolet rays of the sun. So one thing keep in your mind, the ozone layers always protect us. So protect us means, here we need not write to verb, here we need to write down abstract noun. So protects, and through the protects we can make protection. Okay, I hope you have got it, my point. Now move on to question number 4th. Children should avoid movies which depict violent, and through the violent, here violent is what? Violent is here adjective. So through the violent we can make violence. What? Violence. Now move on to question number 5th. Mohit attended her ceremony on Saturday. So here Mary is what? This is verb. So through this verb we can make here abstract noun, marries. What? Marries. So we can say that Mohit attended her marriage ceremony on Saturday. So I hope you have got it, my points. If you have any problem, just try to write down in comment section. And after this lecture we have completed the topic of noun. So next lecture your will be on the topic of adjective. So stay tuned, and may God bless you.